Should you invest in flats or houses? It's one of those debates in property that's never going to go away. A lot of people feel very strongly that one is better than the other, and you often see people on forums making very strong statements about why they would absolutely never invest in flats. And then in the next post, someone will come along and say why they would absolutely never invest in houses. But we're talking about it now because this debate has become particularly relevant in today's property market. But Rob, to start doing that, we need to run through the general kind of perceived pros and cons of houses versus flats. So let's get into that. Do you want to kick us off by making the case for houses?
Yeah, let's do it. Okay. So first of all, houses, you own the land that the property sits on. So with apartments, many apartments anyway, you don't own the land. You have a share of it through a lease, and that lease is often dated at a point in future that will run out. So therefore, it may need renewing. Also, you don't have service charges or ground rent. So with apartments, you'll be paying an annual ground rent, and you'll also contribute to service charges. It'll depend on the size of the apartment block, the facilities that apartment block offers. But with a house, then you do not need to be paying ground rent or service charges. Houses often are bigger as well. Now, again, this could be debated whether this is a pro or a con, but certainly for the people living in it, it would be perceived that this is a pro, and having that bigger space will be appealing. And because of that space and often where the properties are located, you're more likely to attract longer-term tenants, often attract families who are more likely to stay for longer rather than apartments, which tend to be in city centres. And finally, another obvious pro for houses is the likelihood that they'll have more outdoor space than an apartment. Where the world is right now, outdoor space is certainly attractive. The list of pros for houses is pretty strong. Do we end it there, Rob? Is that the end of the episode?
Of course not, because there's no such thing as the perfect investment, and houses are not perfect. So first of all, you are responsible for everything. Now, of course, you can see that as a pro because it means you have control over what you do with your property, but it does mean that there's more to be done. In other words, with flats, you're not paying that service charge for nothing. You could debate how much value you're getting from it, but it does mean that lots of things that you would otherwise need to take care of yourself get done for you. Another disadvantage of owning houses is that there's the potential for higher maintenance costs, and certainly less predictable maintenance costs. So for example, if you need a new roof, which you will do at some point, that is going to be a big, big cost. Whereas in a flat, the roof will still need replacing, but there are going to be more people contributing to that cost. And if the block is run well, then a fund will have been building up to cover that when the time comes, so you don't suddenly get stuck with a higher bill out of nowhere. And finally, another disadvantage of houses, which is nothing really to do with the house itself, but it's that they tend to be further out from the city centre. Why is that a disadvantage? Well, it's not necessarily. It's just that when it comes to the property cycle, which is something we talk about a lot, you tend to get the growth first and fastest in the centre, and then it ripples out from there. So that's some pros and cons for houses. And of course, we couldn't avoid talking about flats as part of that, because it's about comparing one with the other. But let's give flats a bit of attention in their own right. Rob, you're getting to do all the positives today, so do you want to take the pros for flats as well?
Alrighty, let's start with the potential for lower maintenance costs, because as we've discussed, they are covered by the service charges. So you kind of know where you stand with apartments. Sometimes there are big pieces of work that need to happen that will be outside the remit of your normal service charges. So the recent cladding issues have meant that some people have had to pay beyond their service charges for maintenance. But for the majority of the time, for the majority of your ownership, the service charges that you pay each and every month are normally more than enough to cover the maintenance costs. So you need to think about the internals of your apartment, any wear and tear that may take place, but the communal areas, the external block, normally that's something that you just don't need to worry about. That's taken care of for you. And for people who like to be a little bit more hands-off with their strategy, apartments will often appeal. So the convenience of flats is definitely its biggest strength. Location, depends on your point of view, can be better as well. If you want exposure to city centres, then it's going to be a lot harder to do that as a house.
But of course, there are drawbacks to flats as well. One of them is the fact that you are just the leaseholder rather than the freeholder. And some people have like a philosophical problem with this, because you're paying all this money and all you're effectively doing is renting your flat for 150 years or whatever it is. And you can, of course, extend that. There's no need for it to get to the end of that time and you have to hand the property back. But it just feels a bit strange. But all the other disadvantages of flats, I think, could all really be linked in under one, which is a loss of control. So we've already talked about how the existence of a service charge, having to pay that, could be seen as a con, but it could also be seen as a pro, because it means that somebody else is doing all these things for you that you don't have to do. There's going to be maintenance that needs to be done with both houses and flats. The only difference is that with flats, you're paying a large portion of it monthly on a schedule, and with houses, the costs just crop up whenever they crop up. That's just a case of personal preference, but for a lot of people, that is a major con to flats. It feels like they've made an investment that they don't have full control over.
Let's look at some of the common misconceptions there are around owning a house or owning an apartment. And we may have even aided some of these misconceptions because of some of the things we've said. For example, the first one, flats are not always cheaper to purchase. So I've talked about in city centres that flats are normally a way for you to get into the market and they can be cheaper. And that is absolutely the case. They can be cheaper, but they're not always cheaper. And something else is that's not always true is houses always get better capital growth than apartments. That's actually not true. Now, historically, it's actually the other way around. Yes, apartments have outperformed houses, but over the long term, apartments have outperformed houses. Another misconception that's bounded around is that flats are more desirable to rent. Flats will be more desirable to rent for certain markets. Houses will be more desirable to rent for certain markets. But people get fixated thinking one is better than the other. Don't be one of those investors, because the open-minded investors, the ones who use their brain and look what the crowd are not doing, are the ones that make the most money.
So there you have it, houses and flats. For us, there's no clear winner. But what do you think? Let us know in the comments which you prefer to invest in and why.